Doctors of Reddit, what made you say how the fudge is this person still alive? Not a doctor, but firefighter. We had a 30-year-old male put a shotgun in his mouth pointing up to his nose, pull the trigger and survive. We show up work him, he's breathing, but missing most of his face, and we transport him. He survives and we are all amazed. 3 months later he does it again, but a .22 to the temple, it bounced around and exited through his eye. He survives again. With some mental deficits and a glass eye, but still one of the craziest I've seen. Not his time to go, I suppose. Third time is the charm, I guess. At that point I would sign a DNR and pay someone else to try to kill me so we can get it over with. Jesus. Witnessed a sedan with a trailer flip 4 times at 75 miles per hour on a highway into a ditch right in front of me. A 12-year-old wasn't wearing a seat belt and was thrown from the vehicle through an open window. He had a superficial laceration of his leg, and was in shock, but otherwise apparently unharmed. We did a quick trauma evaluation of the family, everyone seemed okay, and applied pressure to the kid's bleeding leg until EMS got there. When we were running to the wrecked car as the dust was settling, I was sure we were just going to see disembodied pieces of that kid everywhere, but he was really, really lucky. Wear seat belts, folks. Everyone who remained buckled in the car didn't even have a scratch. Wear seat belts. Can't stress this enough. We lost a friend of a friend recently because she wasn't wearing her seat belt and was thrown from her vehicle when involved in a sliding to roll over collision a month ago. Mother of three, only 25 years old. Be safe, people. But my buddy at the insert union job trade job got into an accident, and his doctor said the seat belt would have killed him. I have literally never heard of a doctor seriously entertaining this idea. Is this a real thing people believe? There are very rare instances where someone actually survives because they weren't wearing their seatbelt. It happened to my cousin. She was hit on the driver's side, and was thrown into the passenger's seat. The cop that attended told her that if she had been wearing her seatbelt, she would have been trapped and probably killed. Then he proceeded to write her a ticket for not wearing her seatbelt. Of course, statistically, wearing a seatbelt is far more likely to save you than kill you, so anyone saying the above is a complete moron. But yes, it is possible that someone's doctor could tell them that, due to their particular circumstances, wearing a seatbelt could have killed them. I was being sarcastic, which is why I added the open-ended insert here part lol. Doctors are never 100% certain about anything, so if you ask them a ridiculous question like, "Hey doc, if I had the seat belt off, would I have been in worse shape, given the circumstances?" The answer will always be, "Well, it's a possibility." The rising cost of their malpractice insurance will keep them from admitting almost anything. Older woman called 911 for chest pain. Her vital signs were it, and she had the look that anyone who's ever seen a patient about to die will recognize instantly. Her EKG suggested multiple blockages in her coronary arteries, and we had to put her on a ventilator shortly after she got to the ER because she deteriorated so quickly. Cath lab confirmed the EKG findings: complete blockage of one artery and 99% blockage of two other major arteries. Unfortunately, it was too extensive to resolve with PCI, so the only option was to fly her to the university hospital in the city for an emergent triple bypass. It turned out that she'd had multiple episodes like this, but not quite as severe, over the last 6 months, and had refused bypass surgery not once, not twice, but 3 times in favor of a Mediterranean diet. Well, at this point she didn't have much say anymore and family agreed, so off to the OR she went. I took care of her again about 4 months later and she actually seemed to have made a remarkable recovery. She triple bypassed a triple bypass. I refuse to believe people are this witty in the middle of the night. It's morning in some other place in the world. Yeah, look at this piece of wood. Med student here. My most memorable patient was a particularly pleasant middle-aged man who was flown back to my hospital in the Midwest after suffering a 6-story fall from a hotel balcony in the Caribbean. The story goes, this poor fella just arrived at his hotel planning to spend a week in paradise. Immediately upon arriving to his hotel, he stepped out on his balcony to watch the sunset and leaned on the railing only to have it collapse underneath him. He fell 6 stories straight down and suffered bilateral open tibial pylon fractures, which are particularly high energy and difficult to heal. The poor guy apparently fell into a locked backyard and his wife and kids had to listen to him screaming in pain and bleeding for over 2 hours before they could get the fire department to break down the gate. He was taken to the hospital on the island he was staying, where he was stabilized and they recommended he have both legs amputated. He begged to be shipped back to the United States, and apparently, the government got involved and flew him to Miami, where he was externally fixated and transfused several times. I guess he had some internal trauma as well. About a week later, he was shipped up to the Midwest to my hospital. Literally blew my mind the shit this poor guy went through just because he wanted to enjoy a vacation. Sadly, I think that he ended up losing one of his legs anyways because his wounds wouldn't heal and he ended up with osteomyelitis, bone infection. Sounds like the hotel owes him a major payday. The price tag on agony and a lost leg is 8-figure territory. Big ups if you have recent pictures of yourself winning amateur leg-based competition. To leg-based. 3-leg race winner garners no sympathy. Damn shame. 2. You know those big, 16-18-inch kitchen knives that everyone has? Had a lady come in with one sticking sideways out of her neck, handle on the left side and top sticking out the right. She went to war, where they removed the knife in one of the most tense, clenched moments in history, minimal bleeding. Apparently the knife split right between her major blood vessels and airway. Was lying right against them, didn't scratch em. Absolutely incredible. Who has a 16-inch knife? My longest is an 8 inches. I keep impeccable honed. Another 10? That's longer than my rocker pizza cutter. Mistype on my part, I meant 6-8. I have an 18 inches machete, must have been on my mind. My bad. I'm just picturing in my head, honey, I'm going to make some fresh salad and steak. Okay dear, lady proceeds to pull out 18 knife to dice lettuce. Gotta make sure it's a clean kill, those lettuce can be dangerous. 5 confirmed last year. 5 lettuces question mark? Letty? Let us forget this conversation ever happened. It's late and that's my story and I'm sticking to it. Shit, really? Where you hunting? Can't find shit in my local region. Ah yes, the lettuce, second deadliest creature to hunt after my favorite sport, man. Once you take an 18 inches machete to them, they're just vegetables. It's also about sending a message to the other veg. Pineapple got my aunt once while she was on safari. I hear cutting lettuce with a metal knife is bad for the blade. They make plaid lettuce knives. Imagine 18 inches of plastic in your neck. Non-sexually, of course. My dad. Walked a mile to see a friend and tried to walk up the stairs. Couldn't get up one step. Walked back 1 mile to his office, looked up who his doctor was, since he hadn't seen one in 20 years, and drove there. No appointment. DR hooks him up to an EKG, but it's fine. Tells him there's a cardiologist next door, it's the end of the day, they'll see him. Just in case, they hook him up to a blood pressure monitor while he's on a treadmill. The monitor is behind him, he can't see it. He starts walking. They set a countdown timer for 3 minutes, and about 30 seconds in, one of the nurses steps out of the room. My dad is watching the timer and it counts down to 0. He feels fine and figures he's going home, but the door opens and 2 ambulance attendants are wheeling in a gurney. While he was on the treadmill, his blood pressure dropped to 0, then restarted, then dropped to 0 again. The nurse who stepped out of the room dialed 911. They let him finish because they figured as soon as he stopped, the heart attack would start in earnest. Quadruple bypass later and he lived, but note, he said he never felt the same. A bypass is not a panacea. I mean, he went in because he couldn't make it up a single stair. Sounds like his body had reached a point where he wouldn't ever feel the same either way. How did he keep walking? Concentrated power of will. 5% pleasure. 50% pain. And a 100% reason to remember the name. Infantry guy in Afghanistan in 2009. Some old guy came up to us in a bazaar and asked us to give him a ride to a city. His arm was wrapped up. We said no, since we don't exactly do that. He unwrapped his arm. His hand wrist was missing and his 2 arm bones were exposed and white. Everything else was green and black. I have no idea how he was alive, much less up and walking around. What happened after? We had our medic look at it, everyone said whoa. Then we got mortared and got in a fight, so basically we never saw him again. I'm guessing he died within a few days, but I really don't know. I was expecting this, yet didn't expect this.